What's up, guys? My name is Alex, and I'm a dating coach. In this video, we're going to review the movie Hitch and break down various scenes to see if the advice they give is something that would be applicable in real life or is just Hollywood nonsense. All right, so we're going to go through various clips in the movie so I can give you guys my professional opinion. Let's start with this one.
Your glass was getting a little low, so I took the liberty of bringing you another apple martini.
Thank you.
And I couldn't help but notice you look a lot like my next girlfriend.
So this is Hollywood's, you know, portrayal of bad game, and it's actually quite accurate. I mean, this is really fucking shitty game. Variety of reasons. First of all, notice how she's sitting, and he's kind of like sitting slash standing over her, so that's not something you want to do. You're going to notice when Hitch comes in, he actually sits next to her, so I'm actually pleasantly impressed that they got the body language part correct. Secondly, he leaves with a drink. So he's like, oh, I got you an apple martini, right? There's nothing wrong with buying a girl a drink, but you don't want to lead with that. Like, because then, first of all, you put her in a situation where she feels obligated to talk to you. It's like this weird thing. Like, you want the drink to be something like, you know, it's like you're hanging out with your buddy, buy him a drink, but it's not like the main thing you're offering to the dynamic. But the most fucked up thing here is obviously, you know, the pickup line. You do not want to do, you know, gamey pickup lines when you talk to girls in any situation, because you're going to get reactions like this.
What's your name?
They call me Chip.
Ah, you can't get him to stop?
That was funny.
Listen, Chip, I understand the courage it takes to walk across a room and try to generate a relationship out of thin air, so don't take the following personally.
You have fantastic eyes.
Thanks. Try to listen.
And notice how she's being a little condescending, which is common. You're going to get that if you do gamey shit. So this is, so far, 100% realistic.
You, I'm just not interested. But thank you for the compliment of coming over.
You're welcome. So do you like Cuban food?
Jeff, seriously, that was not code word. I wish you'd try harder.
Are you always so shut down and afraid that the right man might make you feel like a natural woman? Sorry I'm late, honey. I couldn't get a cab. How was the meeting?
Oh, well, there was...
So this is actually, now they're going to contrast that with Will Smith's, you know, game. And this is actually a very effective opener in a situation like this. So he basically picks up on the situation, the fact that she's trying to get out of talking to this guy, and he uses that to his advantage. So if you do that correctly, it's actually very effective. So far, this is very much something that, you know, would happen in real life or would work in real life.
A beginning, a middle, and an end. Nice to meet you, Chip.
You too. Now, on the one hand, it is very difficult for a man to even speak to someone who looks like you. But on the other hand, should that be your problem?
So life's kind of hard all around.
So this is also pretty good. He's like basically reading between the layers instead of just having like the, you know, the boring like surface layer talk. Like, so what do you do? What do you like to do for fun? He's commenting on the situation. So this is like an example of the we frame that we talk about quite often. So far, this is actually pretty good game.
I mean, you're sending all the right signals. No earrings, heels under 2 inches, your hair is pulled back. You're wearing reading glasses with no book.
Cold read, also something that's effective if done correctly.
Drinking a great goose martini, which means you had a hell of a week.
Now notice how he's sitting on her level.
And if that wasn't clear enough, there's always the fuck off that you have stamped on your forehead. Because who's going to believe that there's a man out there that can sit down beside a woman he doesn't know and genuinely be interested in who she is, what she does, without his own agenda?
Yeah, I wouldn't even know what that would look like. So what would a guy like that say?
Well, he'd say, my name is Alex Hitchens, and I'm a consultant. But she wouldn't be interested in that, because she'd probably be just...
He's got a good name. I like that. So far, so good.
Counting the seconds until he left.
Thinking he was like every other guy.
Which life experience has taught her is a virtual certainty. But then he'd ask her name and what she did for a living. And she might blow him off. Or she might say...
I'm Sarah Milas. I run the gossip column at the Standard. And then he'd ask all these penetrating questions about it because he was sincerely, if atypically, interested.
No.
No.
He'd be interested.
So here he missed out on a chance to make a nice little sexual joke. All these penetrating questions. So here I would have just kind of jumped on that. I've been like, I do like my questions to be very, very penetrating, right? So this was an easy cue to sexualize, and I think it's important to do shit like that in real life. If you don't, then, you know, the conversation can become platonic.
But he'd see that there was no way he could possibly make her realize that he was for real.
Yeah, he could be funny and charming and refreshingly original.
Wouldn't help.
Don't you hate it when that happens?
Not really. They'd both probably go on to lead the lives they were headed toward. And my guess is they'd do just fine. It's a pleasure to have met you, Sarah Milas.
So this is pure Hollywood. So basically what happens here is he walks away, he gets her name, then he tracks her down. You're going to see in the next clip, he sends her walkie-talkie, right? But this is the fucking Sarah Milas, very common name. In reality, you would never be able to track a girl down. If you did, it would be kind of creepy. So, you know, you don't want to walk away, especially when you make a good impression like him, without getting the girl's phone number, right? So this is pure Hollywood here that, you know, a girl would be cool with you just like tracking down her personal information. If you're super charming and suave, it can't possibly work, but it's a million times easier. Just get her phone number, text her. So yeah, this part is, the ending is pure Hollywood here. All right, let's go to the next clip. So this is the following day. She's at work and he sends her a walkie-talkie, which she got from having her name. Again, Sarah Milas, super common name in New York City, like no fucking way that would actually happen in real life.
I hate it when a guy calls a girl did not give him her number. So this is me not calling. Over.
Yes, you're right. This is much less invasive.
Listen, I've been thinking about that sign on your forehead, and I was wondering if you'd mind taking it down for dinner Friday night. Over.
Oh, I can't. I have a couple of parties I have to hit.
Gossip never sleeps.
Not till about 4 a.m.
Saturday.
I have a date.
Do you know the definition of perseverance, Miss Milas?
An excuse to be obnoxious?
Continuing in a course of action without regard to discouragement, opposition, or previous failure. Over.
Okay, Webster, how do I get rid of you?
Breakfast Sunday.
Yeah, so this is pretty bad. I mean, in reality, this would be considered a pretty poor game. I mean, he's pushing pretty hard to get the meetup. She's just kind of, you know, it's very clear who's the prize here in this interaction. Like, he's the one winning her over. Good game should not look like you're the one that's winning the girl. It should look like almost like she's winning you over, right? So that doesn't always work out like that in real life, but you're going to see a constant theme throughout this movie is the girl gets put on the pedestal, right? And this is definitely something that's not good game in real life. You don't want to put the girl on a pedestal. You want to, you know, basically, you know, treat her like an equal, right? So yeah, this is pretty bad. You know, he's like, Friday, Saturday, how do I get rid of you? I mean, at this point, I would have changed gears a little bit. I would have said, do you really want to get rid of me? Come on now, we both know you don't want to get rid of me. And then get her to be like, okay, haha, I don't, you know, be like, listen, like, it sounds like, you know, you're a little hesitant about meeting. Like, what's up? She'd be like, no, okay, I want to meet, right? Like, kind of get her to invest a little bit instead of just pushing. So, yeah, this is right now a very questionable game.
And you can barely even call that a date. You do that with out-of-town relatives that you don't even like. Over.
And also, I think it's important to point out, like, fucking dinner date, breakfast date, no. Like, you don't want to do fancy dates in real life. The vast majority, it is realistic because the majority of guys do stuff like that. But this is not a good game. Like, good game is meeting a girl for drinks. You don't want to do, you know, dinner dates, and especially not breakfast dates. I don't know if anyone's hooked up from a breakfast date since the dawn of man. So definitely don't want to be doing shit like that.
Okay, I guess I could do Sunday.
You forgot to say over. Over.
This conversation's over as soon as you tell me when and where.
7 a.m. North Cove Marina. Over and
out. Yeah, do not fucking do 7 a.m. anytime. I mean, like, what? Like, in reality, this would not work because Saturday night she would be out and about with her girlfriends. She would get drunk and she would sleep through and she would miss the date. So, yeah, this is like, again, nice in Hollywood, but not something that would ever play out like this in real life. Now, what you're going to see is the date itself. He takes her jet skiing, then he takes her to, like, this fucking, like, Ellis Island, where he tracks down her ancestors, he shows her this book, they go to a museum. It's like a very, like, event-filled day, right? This is not something that you want to do in real life. You don't want a fucking, you know, first date to be, you know, jet skis and all that. Like, you don't want to overdo it on the day. You want to keep things nice and simple. Simple is good. Complex is not good in situations like this. So again, this is again something that works in Hollywood, wouldn't really be effective strategy in real life. Let's move on to the next clip.
Call the kissing post.
So this is during their date.
Black explains how different cultures kiss after long absences. Now what exactly would qualify as a long absence? I mean,
this is actually pretty good. So this is a good game. He's fucking around with a kiss. He's putting the idea in her head that he's going to kiss her without actually doing it. So this is actually pretty good stuff. So I would say this is good game.
3 dates and I'll get you here to the high stakes medal round, where 8 out of 10 women believe that the first kiss will tell them everything they need to know about the relationship.
So this is Hollywood. He's basically making the argument that by the third date you go for the kiss. No. You want to go for the kiss on the first date, right? If you don't, the girl is going to lose respect and think that you're not really interested or that you're gay, right? So you definitely want to go in for the kiss on the first date. Now, if you don't get it, that's okay, but you at the very least want to try. So this is just pure Hollywood nonsense. Oh, 3 days until the kiss. No, that's not really how it works in real life. Certainly not in 21, unless you're going for Mormon chicks or Amish or whatever the fuck it is. All right, so let's move on to the next clip. So here's going to be a shit test.
Well, why don't you tell me, and then we'll both know.
Sarah?
Man, male egos. I don't know how you guys make it through the day with them.
What? No, it is not my ego. I don't want to ruin the surprise.
So yeah, he didn't really, she was giving him a shit test, like male egos. He didn't really pass it. He kind of gets like, oh, it is not my ego. Now, he didn't completely fail it. He didn't get butthurt. He didn't start rationalizing with her. But, you know, when she said, I don't know how you guys make it through the day, I would have said, well, you know, it's a hard job, but someone's got to do it, right? Like, I would probably respond with humor. Yeah, so this is a little bit of a fail, but watch what happens next. So definitely do not kick the girl in the face on the date. That is a little bit of a no-no, in my opinion. All right, let's take a look at this.
60% of all human communication is nonverbal, body language. 30% is your tone. So that means that 90% of what you're saying ain't coming out.
So this is actually very true. I don't know if the numbers are exactly spot on, but most communication is nonverbal, right? It's going to be your body language. It's going to be your tonality. So yeah, he definitely gets this part right. And I'm actually kind of surprised, you know, that, you know, Hollywood movie was able to kind of pinpoint this, but it's very true. What you say really matters a lot less than how you say it. So definitely agree with that. And then let's take a look at one last clip. I wanted to throw this one in here because I find this is the most Hollywood-y one out of the whole bunch.
Not a problem. Wow, you're
So here he's meeting with a new client.
No, I'm fine, thank you. So tell me about her. Have you ever met someone?
So as a dating coach, I would never say, so tell me about her. I would say, so tell me about your situation, right? Because my goal is to help the guy just improve his dating life in general, not like win over one specific girl. If you focus too much on one girl, you actually make it less likely that you're gonna get with her because you become more attached to the outcome. You become more like, you know, just fucking jittery. So this is actually never how I would start a conversation with a prospective client.
And you knew right away she was gonna be important. Not just because of her looks, but you know, that X factor.
How'd you meet her?
Actually, I was in a shop buying pajamas for my mom.
And by that, of course, you mean you were buying lingerie for another woman.
Yes. You can't help when you meet somebody. And the lingerie is for a woman I'm no longer seeing. Oh. So, but anyway, the girl I met, the one I was talking about, she's so sweet, funny, southern. She gives me a number. Now, she won't return my phone calls. I don't know what it is about her. I just can't get her out of my mind. You know, food has lost its taste. Colors, you know, they seem dull. And things that used to matter, I don't know, they just no longer do. I think things aren't going to snap back unless I bang.
Excuse me?
You know, banger. Clear my head. Get in, get off, get out.
I think you may have misunderstood what I do exactly.
No, I was told you help guys get in there.
Right, but see, here's the thing. My clients actually like women.
Huh.
yeah, hit, hit it and quit it is not my thing.
Let me make one thing clear to you, Red.
So yeah, so as a dating coach, you would not, you know, try to judge a client based on what they want. Let's say they want something really fucked up or illegal. I would never, you know, try to shame a client for wanting to have a one-night stand or have casual sex, right? Fucking, there's not, one is not better than the other. Like, I think that Hollywood, this is where Hollywood really, really does a disservice to, you know, young men who, you know, in general, is basically to make it seem like, you know, like one thing, like wanting a relationship is just so much of a higher aspiration than, you know, wanting to get laid. No, they're both in the same category. It just comes down to what you want. As long as you're honest, you know, you're not lying to the person, there's nothing wrong with that. So this is, again, this is like pure Hollywood nonsense. You kind of see, what happens next?
Like women.
Huh.
Yeah, hit and quit it is not my thing.
Let me make one thing clear to you, Rabbi.
Rabbi?
I need professional help.
Well, that is for damn certain. And I'm glad you can admit it because...
Yeah, so basically, I mean, you see a lot of condescension here, like, because he wants a one-night stand, oh, he must be so much worse. But again, as a dating coach, in reality, you would never judge a client, you know, for wanting one thing over another. I mean, again, as long as you don't want anything that's illegal or something that's, like, ethically fucked up, then it's all gravy. All right, hopefully you guys enjoyed this little analysis. I think that the movie has definitely tidbits of practical advice. However, it is very much Hollywood-y. The whole idea, you know, you kiss the girl on the third date, that true love. And I think the biggest thing the movie gets wrong is it really puts the girl on a pedestal, right? Like, you're gonna see this if you watch the movie, like, the guy Hitch and, you know, his little minions, they put the chick on a pedestal and they kind of chase them. That's not really how you should approach dating, and that's not a good game in general. Nor is it going to be really practical because it's not going to be effective. A girl doesn't want a guy who, you know, really is trying to win her over. She wants the guy that she has to win over. So it's kind of paradoxical, but it is the way it is. Hopefully you guys found this valuable. Show us some love by smashing the like button, hitting subscribe, and clicking the bell for notification. Until next time.